people need to understand, whether it's right or wrong, measurables are what get you into the first round. And sometimes that's why you miss.
Yeah.
And sometimes that's why you see a lot of great players in the second or third round, because they throw measurables out because they're not afraid to be wrong on
this. And
those
I think
guys.
He's going to the Senior Bowl, is he not?
Yes, he is.
He said he's going to go to the Senior Bowl,
yep,
yeah.
Exactly. Yeah, to Trey's point, they're using the measurables to try and justify getting you for cheap.
Right.
It may not be exactly. They think you're a bad player. They're just looking for how to get you out of the bargain.
Yeah,
bin.
Why should we buy you for what you may be worth when we can get you for less?
Shamarco right. Thomas was a great safety coming out of Syracuse my rookie year in Pittsburgh, and I remember he was like a second or third round pick for them, and Mike Tomlin looked at him and said, we got you in that round because you're a sawed-off linebacker. Because you're shorter right. than the expectations need you to be for this. And so that could be what happens for Baker. But yeah. I it's interesting with all these guys, because nowadays this puts more onus on coaching in the NFL than maybe ever before. And we've seen the Sean McVays of the world, the teams that have made it work, they overuse play action pass. They put these guys in position. You need great coaching to try and mask up what some of these offenses aren't going to create for you.
And again, this will be the process for the next 3.5 months.
Yes, it
for
will.
Baker Mayfield. But he will be that guy. He'll be the swing vote that has everybody's eyes on the draft, and that's why it's going to be a lot of fun with four, maybe even, depending on what happens with Lamar Jackson, a five potential quarterbacks.
And you got Mason Rudolph.
Absolutely.
Well.
Who is a big, strong guy that can sling it.